In this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up and work with approvals from business process flows in your model-driven app. Same thing actually for Dynamics 365. Here we have an equipment order that's just come in. Someone in my organization has decided they would like a new blue office chair, and that has to be approved by the procurement manager. It's come into the application, the order's been received, we move along to the next stage, and there's a button here to say request approval. The person who's making the request can put some additional information in here to justify why they want this blue chair, and run that approval flow. All good, I can click done. You'll see that triggers a notification in Teams to the procurement manager. And what we're working with here is the approvals app that's part of Power Automate and that you can work with in Teams. If you haven't used this before, over on the three dots here, you can choose find an app. And if you type in approvals, you can select that there and then pin it to the sidebar. And what happens, this is all ready to go. I can see I'm the procurement manager. Sam has sent me an approval request. We've got the comments that Sam put in. I can actually click here and that will open the record in the model-driven app if I wanted to get some more information. And then from in here, I can decide that's fine and I'll be generous today and approve that request. And I've got a record of all of the things that I've approved sitting right there in Teams. Let's go back and have a look at the model-driven app now. We'll give this a refresh and you'll see that comes through with my approval status. So how do we put all of this together? Let's go through it step by step. So first of all, we need to have some columns on our table here to receive the approval information. As always, working in a solution here, I'm going to go into my equipment ordering solution. I'm working in the equipment order table, and you'll see I've created two columns here. The first one is approval status. This is a choice column that has two options in it, approved and rejected. You can actually have custom responses with the approvals app if you want. I'm just going straight down the line for the most basic option here. And the other one here is the approval date, which is just a simple date only field. That's all we need as a starting point to set it up. The rest of the work is done using Power Automate. So again, within my solution here, I can come into Cloud Flows and I'm going to add a new automation, a new Cloud Flow, and this will be an automated Cloud Flow. That's actually going to open Power Automate inside my solution window here. I'm just going to skip over this because I prefer to create it from the main canvas. So the first thing I'm going to do is find my trigger. And the trigger is that I want to set up that button, which is called the flow step, inside the business process flow. And that's actually part of Dataverse, which is the database that's sitting underneath all of this beautiful stuff. So there we go. There's my trigger. When a flow step is run from a business process flow, so I can just select that. And this is where we can choose that input. So that experience on the screen that we had earlier where I could enter in the information to justify it, I've done that by saying that I want a text input and I've given that the name comments and that's how it comes up. You can do whatever you like here. If you want people to enter other things in here, you can add additional things and give them whatever names you want and that's where it will pop up on that screen. Or if you don't need anything at all, you can actually just leave that step out entirely. Next step here is that we want to trigger an approval. So we're going to find the standard connector here for an approval by typing that in. And you'll see we've got three options here. We can start and wait for an approval, which is the one we're going to do. That will actually allow us to trigger an approval and the flow knows to wait for a response because what we want to do is when the response comes in is go back and update the model-driven app. So that's what we're doing there. There are some other options here. I tend not to use them. One is create an approval, but the flow doesn't then wait for any kind of update or wait for an approval if you've got something else that's got the incoming approval that this flow will pick it up. So we're going to go for this one here. And then we can select our approval type. And you'll see here you've got some options to play with. You can actually set up your standard approve reject, which is what I'm working with here, either as the first person to respond, so it can go out to multiple people or single person, just needs that one person to respond, or you can send it out to multiple people and have it that everyone has to approve. Same options here, but also with custom responses. So if you wanted something like approve, pending, please review, reject, or something like that, you can do that in there as well. Let's just go with the simplest one here as an example, which is first to respond. First thing we're going to do is give it a title, and the title ends up here. So you'll see the previous one I had was called Equipment Order Test. Let's give it a slightly better name this time so we can go up here. So Equipment Order Approval. Then we choose who we want to assign it to. Now, in this case, if I've got a procurement manager who's going to approve all of these things, I can just choose that person from in there. You could also use dynamic content in here to choose an individual person or bring in an Office 365 connector to find the person's manager. Those are more advanced things for another video. Let's just go with choosing a particular person for now. Next thing we can put in is the details. You'll see this supports Markdown and there's a link there, which I'll also put in the description. If you want to learn how to do Markdown, please go ahead, but I'm just going to keep this nice and simple here by putting in a single piece of dynamic content. So we can pull something that's come out of the previous steps here, which is the comments that we had in the start. I just type that in there, select it, that pops it in there, and you'll see what happens is that that comes up here. The next thing I'm going to show you is how we can create that item link, which is this part here that says click here to view details and takes you through to the model-driven app. Item link is the most advanced thing I'm going to show you here. As you work with content in your business process flow, you can actually bring in anything that the flow knows about. So the concept here is that this has come from that business process flow. So in the trigger step, it's aware of that unique instance of that business process flow that's come through. And then anything that's related to that, we can draw into the flow. And as I said, this can get quite advanced. Most of what I'm showing you here, I'm keeping it nice and simple. But one little trick that I do want to show you here. So I'm going to click in here. Let's scroll down to get a bit more space. And what I want is something related to the BPF, the business process flow. And you'll see there's a whole bunch of stuff here. Now, I'm going to be honest. Learning this stuff is as much about sort of going through a bit of trial and error, or reading the documentation, understanding how these pieces are put together. I'm just going to show you the right choice here. So what we're doing is we're working with that business process flow that is linked to a table. So if we go back in here, the business process flow is here. That is linked to the equipment order table. And what I'm looking for is the ID, the unique record of that particular equipment order table. I don't actually want the flow. I want the table underneath because I want them to be able to click through to that. So what I'm looking for here is the business process flow. And I'm going to scroll down until we find it. So I actually want the one that is related to the table. So there we go. The business process flow stage table row ID. That's actually the one that we want to work with here. And what that's giving me is that unique ID for that record. We're not quite done because that is not a link. That's just an ID number. It's like a great big long unique ID. So if we go back into the application here, you'll see in the URL, I've got my link to the model-driven app and a whole lot of other gobbledygook about the page and the record and so on. And see at the top here, we've got equipment order ID equals, and this is this unique value. So far in the flow, all I've done is retrieve whatever that will be, but that's not a full link. So what I'm going to do here is grab the rest of that URL all the way back to the HTTPS, back into here, and then my link, just go to the other side of it, Control V to paste that in, and now I've created a URL that will go to that model-driven app, and the variable dynamic component will be the unique ID. Then we want to have a link to the item description. So again, we see in here that's created that URL, and I want to put something at the top of it that's a bit friendlier there, so we're going to pop in click here to view details. That's as much as it needs. There are some advanced options in here, some more things that you can do. You can start to add attachments, enable or disable assignment and notifications and things, more that I'm going to cover here. Let me just show you here that we can bring in the name of the requester, the person bringing it in. Again, that can be dynamically brought in from that trigger that came in. So again, scroll down here and we can have a look through here. You can scroll through and see all of these things and sort of browse it. And I can see that we've got the username and the user email in here. It's actually the user email that we want that will register who that requester is. All right, so now what we've got in our flow is when that step is executed, start and wait for an approval. Let me just pause here and show you what it looks like when you're doing this for the first time, because you will get this error message that makes it look like something's not working. All that's telling you is that the first time you do this, it has to, in the background, it has to do some work for you of deploying this approval solution. This is just a one-off thing. You'll see when I'm making it now, I'm not getting that error message. But it does mean the first time you do this, you just have to be cool and ignore that error message. Run your flow for the first time. You'll find it can take a few minutes in the background. It used to take about 20 minutes. When I did this recently, it was about 5. And it will actually deploy for you the full solution that allows you to do all of this automated approval. So that's just a one-off thing to be aware of the first time. And after you've done that once in your environment, you won't see that again. Back to our flow here. Remember, we're using start and wait for an approval. So we've now started the approval. Flow knows to wait for a response, so now we want to put some things in to go back and update that model-driven app with the approval response. So we're going to go down here and add another new step. Now, the other thing I really should do here before I go too much further is save the thing. It's got untitled. Let's just go into the top here, and we're going to call this equipment order approval request and save. Should have done that earlier. By the way, if you're getting value out of this video, make sure you hit that like button so that more people will find it. So now what we want to do is add a control here, and you'll see it's suggesting it for me, which is the condition. But if you can't find that, just start typing in the word condition and you'll find it in there. And this allows us to do a branch. The condition is based on what came back from that approval. You'll see there's lots of things that are coming back out of that approval step. The one that I want here is called responses approver response. And you'll see the description there, the response from the approver. Don't freak out, you'll see it's put an apply to each in here. That's to allow for the fact that if I'd used one of the options where multiple people needed to approve, it would need to go through that loop more than once. For my flow here, doesn't really matter, no harm, whatever, we just keep going. You'll see my condition is still inside here. So now what we want is the responses is equal to, and the standard option here is approve. So that's what we're looking for. Did it approve? Then yes, we're going to go and update it one way. No, it's a rejection. It's going to go down the other path here. So when we go into the approval stage here, what we want to do is update that row back in the model-driven app. So I'm going to add an action here. This is a Microsoft Dataverse action. And always just scroll down a little bit here. I'm going to update a row because I want to go back and update the row. First thing I need to do is say, which table am I updating? So it's the equipment orders table. We can choose the drop down here and just start typing that. No, just be careful. We're updating the equipment order, not the process. We're actually updating something that sits on that table. So now we have to tell it which particular row. This is the same concept as what we did before when we were finding that unique URL. So we're going to click in here. We get our dynamic content. Again, I'm going to go back to the BPF and find it. And we'll scroll down here, and there it is again, the BPF flow stage table row ID. And we put that in. So it knows now it's that unique one that it's updating. And now we choose what information we want to update in here. So advanced options will give me all of the different columns that I've created on the table. I can choose which ones matter to me here. So here we go. Here's my approval status. And I want to update it. That's picking out the choices that I put in before, approved or rejected. So I'm going to choose approved here. I can also put in the approval date. So again, let's just scroll down and see what else we've got here. It's a bit smart. It knows that it's a date column. So it's giving me things that are going to fit that. So this is coming out of that start and wait for an approval step. And I actually want the completion date, the date that it was actually approved. So we'll put that in there. Oops, I clicked it twice. Reckon that's a pretty good start. You can see there's a bunch of other things in the flow that I could update here, but that's as far as I want to go. We can also copy all of this across to the reject side. So first thing we want to do here is give this a more sensible name. So we're going to rename this to update to approved. We're going to grab this from here, copy to my clipboard, and then come over to the no side, add an action, go to my clipboard, and I can choose it from there, and you'll see it's just replicated it there. Now, we don't want update to approve, so the first thing I'm going to do is fix the name. So we're going to update to rejected, open this up, and make one change here, because all of the other things are the same. We're finding the same table, the same name, same approval date, but in this case, we want to update it to rejected. All right, we're done. Now, one more thing here is that we need to go back and tell our business process flow that we need a button that's going to trigger this flow. Back here into my solution, I've already got the business process flow built, so we're going to change it. It's the equipment ordering process here, and I want to add it into the approval stage. So I just open this up, click on my components, and I'm going to choose this here flow step and drag that across into there. We need to give it a name, so we're going to call this one request approval because that's the title that will come up above the button for the user. And then we select the flow that we want to go with that. So that's the one that I've just done there, equipment order approval request. You'll see it's in the list. We click apply and then update the business process flow to take in that change. All right, let's give it a run, shall we? Back to our app, give that a refresh to pick up the latest changes. Brand new order here. Let's move it along to the next stage. Run that flow. You'll see the first time around, this is going to prompt you to log in. This is just a one-off thing the first time to authenticate everything with that. So we just go through that continue step. We don't have to do that every other time. Love this chair, can put in my justification, run the flow, done. And there we go, that's come through to Dan. Click and open the details and make sure that that's working. All good. But he's going to reject it. And let's just see what happens now. Rejected in the list. Back to my model-driven app. Let's give that a refresh. Oh, very sad. If you'd like to learn how to stage gate the business process flow so that you actually can't go ahead if it's been rejected, check out my next video. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know if you've got any questions in the comments.